Welcome back to another episode of Desire to Inspire, yo mama's favorite podcast. We got another beautiful day out, even though it's shitty and gloomy out.
It's actually getting bright out right now. When I walked up, the rain stopped and it's starting to brighten up.
Oh, beautiful.
I ran in the rain though, not a fan.
I don't think there's anything I hate more than the rain.
Snow? You like rain, snowboard in the rain?
100%. Way more.
So today's rain was different. Today's rain wasn't that bad. It was more that annoying rain. It wasn't like overly... like horrible rain.
Yeah, it's just something about you can't do anything. Like the snow, you can at least go out in and not get.
Oh, I went out.
Well, that's because you're on a different wavelength right now.
I feel like I've only ran in the rain, like every time. Like I specifically did my run early today because I knew we were recording midday. Of course, then it rains and now it's done. Like normally I'd go now. Can't.
Nope, you can't. It's all right though. Yeah, the rain. You step outside, you're fucking wet. And it's just, it's not enjoyable. You can't do anything fun in rain.
No.
Nothing. So that's my stance on rain. I have beef with it. But I have beef with it. We're going to have a beautiful day, even though it's not beautiful out. I know you're dying to crack this thing, so you might as well talk about it.
Cool, dude. Honestly, I was thinking, so I've actually never seen these in a gas station. I just happened to go to a gas station I don't normally go to the other day.
Oh.
Like I was leaving... a run, actually, and I was like, oh, let me just grab... I'm getting gas anyway. Let me just grab some drinks now because I'm going to need one before work. It was already early. I was dying. And I was like, holy shit, they got First Phorm Energy drinks here. So, snagged a couple, swung back through today, snagged a couple more. And I don't know if I've ever been so excited at the fact that we're partnered up with a fucking energy company now.
Yeah. I'm excited.
I hadn't put that piece together until I saw it in the store.
They have a six-pack... And so when we re-up this coming month of just stuff that we need, I was going to order a pack of that because it's got like all the flavors.
This will be the third one I tried so far.
Have you tried the American flag one?
I don't know if I want to talk about it. I wasn't a fan.
Fuck.
So here's what I was going to say. I am an avid energy drink consumer. For everyone who watches this, you know this. These don't, from what I've had so far, I'm going to see about this one. They don't have as much bite, like as much carbonation as like a normal energy drink would have.
Okay.
So you might actually like it more.
It's probably because
there's electrolytes.
That and it's coming from green tea.
Yeah, I think that could be it also.
Yeah.
But there's, so the American flag one, I almost got you that one today, but I wasn't a fan. So.
Okay.
And I don't know if it was that I'm necessarily actually not a fan or if there's another company that they have one that's like American flag branded and it's the same kind of a flavor and it's so fucking good. That's what I was hoping for, and it just didn't hit that for me.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, let me try some of these other ones and find one that I actually, like, that's going to be, like, my staple one.
Okay. Well, as you guys know, First Phorm, in this case, energy. This is my first time trying their energy drinks. As you heard, Dylan's tried them before. But zero sugar. Like you said, these ones have electrolytes.
See, this one's better.
Green tea.
This one is
the natural source of caffeine in them.
I had a blue raspberry one also, and it was better than that one too. So I think it's just, I could just have that mental block.
Oh, I don't mind this.
Yeah, it could be the mental block where I want that extra kick from the other one that I found.
Yeah, it doesn't have like how the white one that I usually get has a little bit more, like you said, caffeine to it.
Yeah.
But I don't mind this at all. Supposedly they redid this formula, the orange, because I guess in the beginning when they first came out with it, it was awful.
Yeah, this one's pretty good too, actually.
There's also new products in the works, which we can't talk about now, but I'm excited for them, dude.
Yeah. I've been using like the Ignition, which is basically like their carb formula. Dude, I feel bad even saying out loud because I was with them for so long, but it's so much better than BPNs.
Let's go.
The mixability is insane.
Really?
It has like all the same effects throughout the run, but the mixability and the taste is so much better.
We love that, baby.
I was like,
First Phorm. Dude, you sent that email out the other day, just like letting people know about it and seeing our logo with like the First Phorm under it. I was like, oh, that looks sexy.
Yeah. I had to look for that one. I couldn't find a good one. I put like four logos in there before I decided on that one.
I like that. They have, which I'll kind of put it out because we're definitely going to make it a point to go to it, but they have this, it's called like Summer Smash or Summer Something. And I think it's after this 8-week challenge that they have going on, and it kind of like kickstarts the summer and brings like everybody together. And from my understanding, it sells out within like an hour. Like, it's a very high demand. We obviously will get like first access to it.
Yeah.
So we'll make it a point to go. It's in, where is it in? It begins with an M.
Is it at their headquarters?
Yeah.
It's in like St. Louis.
St. Louis, yeah, Missouri. Yeah. So we'll definitely make it a point to go to that. But I say that right now to put it out there for anybody else.
Dude, I always told myself I'd never go back to Missouri.
Yeah, there's not much there. I'm
that's very where I sad did fucking training, dude. That's where my entire basic training was. There's nothing.
One of my
St. Louis isn't as bad as where I was, but still.
It's not great. One of my really good friends, best friends from Texas, grew up there. And so we kind of give her shit every time we get into that airport. That airport is trash.
I don't know if I've ever been in their airport.
You're not missing anything.
I would have had to be.
Oh, yeah. If you were stationed there. I don't know. It's only something you will know.
And even I don't know.
I think we talked last episode how I've kind of like... We talked last episode about the things... that question that somebody asked me. Like, what are my physical goals? And I think mm-hmm. they're more aligned with like personal and professional goals than they are physical this year. But just want to say that there's going to be a lot more things and capabilities because we said goodbye to Lifetime Fitness.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Let's get into this for a sec. Because I've been curious about like where this transition came from. Because you were fucking balls deep in Lifetime's ass for a second.
Yeah.
You were all about it.
Yep.
Why like the quick switch up of like, I don't want to be here anymore?
One, the drive.
How far is it?
Anywhere from like 20 to 30 minutes, depending on traffic. Okay,
that's a lot.
So it's like an hour to an hour and 10, 15 minute driving a day. Every gym that I've had since I've been out of college, so for the last, 7 years, something like that, has always either been in walking distance or like a 5 minute drive, both in Dallas and then here. Lifetime was a drive, and it was like, all right, this is the best. I was so excited about it because it wasn't the Crunch Fitness. It wasn't the Life or Anytime Fitness. It wasn't the LA Fitness. You're feeling
luxury, dude.
I was. And so I was like, dude, fuck yes. And I always look at the amenities and I'm like, this is fucking awesome. I don't ever use them unless it's a sauna. Like, those are that's the only amenity I use.
That's how they get you, though.
Yes.
They have all this shit that no one uses.
And so we were all like, yes, this is great. Because, again, it is amazing for what the other situations were. And those gyms are great for the crowds that need to go to them or want to go to them. But, like, I'm the type of person that likes a gritty gym, that likes a grungy gym, that likes a gym where you go in and you just, you can feel people putting in the work and the energy. And as I was testing out gyms and trying them all, because we signed up for Lifetime, and then I was going to Crunch to see if I like that, because it's 4 minutes down the road. I was going to the LA, and so were the girls.
Crunch is cheap. That's what,
$10 a month.
They're trying to reel me back in, because that's the old gym that I used to go to. They just, Crunch is about to open there. And I'm like, I don't know where I'm living yet, so like, I can't commit to this. Yeah.
So as we're trying them, I'm like, fuck this. I know what I'm missing. And it was that grit, that grunge, that like high fitness, that trophy fitness type vibe.
You about to put a sauna in the garage?
And we'll get there. and so as I was trying these out, I was like, you know what? It's not that Lifetime sucks, but it's that Lifetime can't offer that aspect of it. So I need to find a non-commercial gym. So there's Hive that's 30 minutes down the highway. There's Core 24 that just opened here. Those are both really dope fucking gyms. Is that like the
influencer gym?
Yeah.
Dude, so there's like a big influencer. I didn't know he moved here, but he goes there.
Who is it?
His name's Alex Eubank.
Okay.
Younger dude, super like aesthetic is like his, like that's like his thing. But he's also like super Christian. Like he's really pushing Christianity a lot.
Yeah.
Which like, I actually just watched a video of his yesterday where it's like, he said like he's been struggling. Like he's like, I'm losing followers. Like I'm not getting the engagement like that I was. But he's like, but then like somebody told me like, hey, dude, keep up the Christian content. And it was like, okay, like I'm not looking for the 100 people. I'm looking for the one person that I can help right
now. It's kind of like George Janko, dude. Yeah. Look at him now.
Yeah.
He's fucking thriving.
But yeah, I didn't know he was here and he's been at that gym. And that gym actually looks sick.
Dude, it's like, fucking dope.
But I feel like if I go in there, it's just going to like, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get the workout that I want to get because everybody's like so in like the influencer lane.
Yeah. I think you would. From my understanding, the way the guy put it is that it's so new right now that it's not like over congested.
I think they have a cap too.
Okay.
They like they're going to cap members at a certain point.
Yeah. Because it's Phil not went and big.
Checked it out. Yeah. Phil said it was dope.
It is. I'll send a video so that way you can put it in here and UNN? Give people. Yeah. I went and checked it out. And so that was last Friday because I went into the office, had to check a couple things at the plant. I was like, this gym is right here. It's like 4 minutes down the road. Let me go check it out. Walked in and I was like, wow, this is a fucking vibe. You go in, the music's loud. There's fucking people just clinking weights. The weights are all like, all the machines are black. They got like dope pictures and lighting. They got Arnold doing his pose like as you're walking into the gym.
Someone's like the tunnel?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so it was really cool. And I was like, all right, maybe we could swing this. But then I GPS'd it and it was like 35 minutes at that time of day. And I was like, fuck. So I was on the phone with Tone and I was telling him because we were going to try and meet up for lunch real quick. But that didn't end up working out. And so as we're driving back, call the girls and Lowe's like, well, there's this gym in South Park that we could look at too. And I was like, how far is it from the house right now? 30, 35 minutes. I was like, God damn, that's like everywhere. So much driving every single day. And I already adjusted my mornings. It'd be
different for me who goes like 3 days a week.
Yeah, very.
But and every day is crazy.
Exactly. And so going to Lifetime, I get up earlier. I get up at like 4:15 so that way I can leave to get there by like 4:45. And so I move my day forward to still do that, but to get home even later.
Yeah.
Because of the drive on the way back. So all that to say, Tone and Nikki have been just boasting up their home gym because it's so convenient. It's nice. It works for what they need. You guys should get one, all this stuff. So I'm like, there is no way in hell I'm getting a home gym. Then the girl started to get the buy-in and it was like, we should get a home gym. And I was like, fuck no. After I visited that last gym and I realized how far it was, I was like, fuck it. Let's get the home gym. I started looking into it. We got Nike strength stuff. It's coming in. It should be in today. Like by the time I have this, there should be something up.
Go over, especially like you guys have three memberships, what that's going to cost for a year. You could put together a home gym and then it's done forever.
It'll be like a 5 month ROI.
Yeah.
With
and then it's good for life.
Yeah. Like,
that's just not going to go bad for years.
Yep. It'll be, it's an 8 month ROI for what we're paying now. But when you consider the gas for both vehicles and our time driving, it's like 4 or 5 months. Yeah. So it's worth it. We're extremely excited about it. We're going to build it out in the garage. And then hopefully we'll be able to film more content and stuff around that as well.
I was about to say, you about to become a fitness vlogger, dude?
I don't know. I might put more stuff out there. I've been having a lot of conversations. I just had one yesterday that I haven't told you about somebody that's looking to lose 24 pounds by September. Super achievable. And so I was like talking to them about it and it just like, I don't know, is an area that I could see not fully getting into it, but like being mic'd up during my workouts. And as I have thoughts come, just kind of like talk like
mics
I do those.
Here.
Yeah.
Actually, I have them. I need to bring them back.
Oh yeah. I forgot you took them. But as I'm having thoughts and stuff while I'm working out, all right, cool, I'll talk. And then I can clip it and then make like little videos out of it. So it's something that I might do. I mean, I'll have it here. Why not? The reason I don't do it now is because I don't want people looking at me. So now I don't have to worry about that or be self-conscious about it.
Core 24 too.
Yeah, I couldn't do that. But yeah, I'm excited. So by the time this drops, there should already be pictures posted on our social media. Just showing the setup and the build
out
of the
gym. In the next 2 days?
Yeah. It should be in today.
Oh, shit.
Yep.
Yeah. So you put a sauna out there?
That is being talked about.
Because that'll really make me make this drive a lot more.
It's being talked about. There's some things happening that could make that happen. But I also might just pump the brakes a little bit. Let's get acclimated. Let's
get the gym in first.
Yeah. Because I got to get an incline bench still. And then that really should complete what we need for the start of it. But a cold plunge and a sauna are like very high on the priority list.
Zach and like Mike Donatelli and them, they've been doing like fire and ice sessions.
Uh-huh.
Whereas they jump from like one to the other. They do like 4 or 5 rounds of this shit.
Yep.
And it's dope. I would definitely want to do that.
Yeah.
Summertime would be sick.
Maybe if we get big enough, we can get one sent to us for free and use it.
I should talk to him because I think he got his sauna sponsored.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That'd be fucking sick.
Yeah, I've talked to him. I'm missing our team call right now to be on this podcast. But
priorities.
But yeah, I'll have to talk to him this week.
How's that going?
It's going good. That's where the quote from today is going to be from.
Let's hear it, brother.
Oh, this is going to be like jumping into like some deeper conversation though. So I don't know if you want to keep it light for a minute or if we're just going all the way in.
Let's go all the way in.
All right. So I actually, this is from last week's call and we're in like a goal setting phase. So like the whole first 8 weeks of the year is when most people would be setting goals, this and that. And their whole mentality behind like not doing that was that everyone does that. And then come mid-February, early March, you feel like a failure because you haven't done anything. So for like the first 8 weeks, it was all about creating space. It was doing food fast. It was doing phone fast. It was like about finding time for yourself. Where do you have time in the day? How much free time do you actually have? Like just creating this space, like to kind of set yourself up for success. Mm-hmm. And now we've went into, we're in like the third week of goal setting. So we've went through like fitness goal setting, relationship goal setting, and now career goal setting was last week. Mm-hmm. And there's like another, what? Go ahead. It's all relationships, Frederick. This is a relationship, bud. Any relationship that you're in your life. But so we're going through like these different goals. And so last week, Petey, which is the pastor of the two mentors here that are leading this group, mm-hmm. he said this quote, and I went back to the call afterwards, listened to it again, and then rewound it again. I was like, all right, I need to write this down because this is good. And it's fucking, it goes back to like a few episodes ago. I remember, like I said, I feel like I'm in like this, some kind of like an evolution of life. And we'll get into it deeper once I read this out.
Okay.
But basically, guys, I came prepared today. I don't have the phone, so I had to write a note by hand. But it says, if you're going to be great at anything, on top of being great at your job, being a great partner, a great friend, and overall a great man, just know you're going to be saying no to a lot of the things that you loved as a boy. It's time to be a man. And I heard it and it hit, but like he kept talking. So I was like, okay. So that's why like I went back. I'm like, okay. Like this is kind of speaking to like where we're at right now, because all of these things are areas that we're focused on, but we're also focused on DTI, which is like something on top of everything else that not everyone has. Like not everybody has this like extra thing, and not even that, but like it's a super important thing, like that is at the forefront of everything. So it also goes back to what you were saying last week about like saying no to things and this and that. And so I don't know, I've just been reflecting on a lot this last week and like what that actually means. And the easy one is what we talked about last week. Mm-hmm. But I don't necessarily even think like that that's where it goes. I journaled about it today, and it more comes down to like complacency and just being lazy and being distracted and like all of these things that are really just like keeping me from doing what I know that I need to be doing.
Will you read it one more time?
Sure. If you're going to be great at anything, on top of being great at your job, a great partner, a great friend, and overall a great man, just know you're going to be saying no to a lot of the things that you loved as a boy. It's time to be a man.
When you read that, what was the first thing you thought of, or like first area or situation in your life?
When I first heard it, I don't know if I necessarily had like an area that jumped out right away. Mm-hmm. It was just more like a compounding effect of like, yeah, it's time to get your shit together.
Yeah.
And I mean, that comes down to a lot of things. Transparently, it's been a rough week. Like, I'll say that right now. Mm-hmm. And not even that, but I wouldn't say it's been a rough couple months. But realistically, I haven't had a job since early February.
Yeah.
We're coming up on April now. So I'm going 2 months without, like, a solid, like, concrete job. So, like, that sense of stability is gone. Had some shit go down last week that, like, I can't even say go down because I knew it was happening. I knew that this was a thing. But it was a tough conversation to have, but it needed to be had.
Yep.
And it changed some things within my life. Well, like drastically changed things within my life. And so like when he said this, I was like, okay, like it's time to get your shit together. It's time to like, if you want all the things that you say you want, are you going to be able to sacrifice things to become the man that you have to be in order to get those things? And so that was where my first train of thought went.
Yeah. Yeah. It's weird. Kind of how like things fall in place at like almost the right time, because I feel like over the last few weeks you and I have kind of like touched on this topic without knowing what that like overarching like bullet point or quote could be to like tie things together to make it make sense. But it resonates a lot because I feel like I'm in this like really weird point of life where I'm like overanalyzing everything and overthinking a lot of stuff, whether it's how people think of me, what people say about me, if I'm doing the right things, if I'm working as hard as I should, if I should restructure goals, if I should restructure my life in different areas. Like, there's just so many things that like my mind keeps racing about, but and it's also creating like a demotivation in other areas. So I've said on here openly, like my workout routines have just been going through the motions. They haven't had that fire that I like them to have. This Spartan race that's coming up, I don't have like the charisma or spark that I had for the first one. Like everything, like I just feel as if I'm almost emotionless.
I feel that with this 12-hour race.
Do you?
Yeah, like it's 2 weeks away.
Mm-hmm.
And like there's no like, I'm not like excited for it. I'm kind of dreading it in a sense. Like I've trained for it. I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
I'm going to try to win it. But like if I win it, I think that fire will come back. But like there's no like, I don't know. It's just odd. I understand 100% what you're saying.
What areas or like, so understanding what I'm saying in that, what action are you taking? Because I think it's very easy to like talk about these things, but then I feel as if once they're talked about from anybody, there's never really like a result or an action that's put in place. So how are you, for instance, not having a job, are you sticking to the goals that you had of like maybe, because I remember four or five episodes ago,
mm-hmm.
you said this is my time to go all in on DTI to make that impact. This is my time to go in on this. Do you feel as if you've used that time that you've had those 2 months?
No. And that's where the first thing I said was complacency and laziness.
Mm-hmm.
Or the very first thing that came up, literally journal about today. And I was like, this is like not, and I feel like just that lack of structure allows everything else to fall apart.
Yeah.
And I could enforce that structure upon myself 100%. Mm-hmm. And so like, I've still been applying jobs. I missed the 1 week of the vlog that was not even necessarily missed. I just knew I shouldn't post it. So yeah. I didn't post it. And so like everything's been consistent, but it's like, has it actually been elevated or is it still where it was? Same with like everything. Like my book that I've been writing, I just finally cracked down and like got back into it last night. I've been stuck.
I almost texted you about that 2 days ago.
I've been stuck on chapter 8, dude, for 3 or 4 weeks.
Damn.
Like, I've written it, I've rewritten it, and I've rewritten it again, and I don't like any of them. And so yesterday, I just printed out the entire book. And I went, took Ziggy to the dog park, and I just, like, sat down and reread it and, like, edited it all by hand. And now, like, I feel like I have a direction. Like, I read it all, and I know where I'm going. And so, like, I'm doing things to get myself back on track. But I'm also, like, applying to jobs, and I went to an office for an interview the other day.
Wow.
For, like, an in-position, or, like, an in-office position. And a big part of me is like, you don't want to be in an office. You don't want to. But like also, has the last 3 years from home been beneficial for you? Or has it allowed you to like slip into a complacency where you can slack off during the day and not feel bad about it because you're getting paid?
Mm.
And like do things that aren't necessarily productive. Where if you're in the office from 8 to 5, are you then going to use the hours outside the office to be productive because you have no other choice?
So you're almost saying that having that structure or that thing that you're going in that's taking so much of your time where you can't fuck off will make those hours outside of it more productive than mm-hmm. having that time day in and day out.
Yeah, I'm going to have to train early. I'm going to have to work on my own shit late. And that's just going to be how it is.
Yep.
And I haven't accepted a position or anything yet, but like I'm kind of shifting my mindset to, okay, going to the office isn't a bad thing. And I've looked at it as like this thing like that I've been trying to avoid for so long. But realistically, it's the way that everything operated up until 3 years ago anyways.
Yeah.
This whole idea of being remote is new. And I'm like, you don't want to be remote. Like, or you don't want to go into the office. You can't hang out with anybody. I'm like, no one fucking hangs out during the week. Like, we do this.
Yeah.
And, like, we fit stuff in. But, like, realistically, most people are still working until 5 and then people do stuff.
Yeah. That was, like, one of the things that was, like, a determining factor for us to invest in the at-home gym. Amanda was like, well, I like being social and like going to the gym and having that environment. And Lo and I were like, yeah, but how social are you? Like, do you talk to people?
Right. Are you hanging out with people at the gym?
No. And I was always the person that had the mentality where I will always go into a gym. a gym is like a barbershop. You go in there, it's refreshing, you're out of your element, yeah. You work hard, you grind, you see the people around you working hard, so you go harder. And then I started realizing, like, I don't look at one person and be like, oh, wow, they're going hard, I'm going to go harder anymore. Like, there's just this, again, I think the environment and the atmosphere puts more into it than the things in that environment and atmosphere.
Yeah.
So, again, if you have a situation where you have this, like, dream gym where it's just got that environment that you like, whether there's no one person in there or 30 people in there, you still know that you're going in there to get that fucking work. And it's the same thing with an office setting. So for me, I've always had to have a desk working at home. I know people that work at home on countertops, in their bed, on couches and stuff like that. Like, I have to have a designated spot to do my stuff. My bed, I don't sit in there and hardly ever watch TV. I don't sit there and go on my phone. I don't sit there and read. I use the bed as my brain, to tell my brain, like, it is bedtime, we're going to bed. Mm-hmm. Now, there'll be occasions where we go in there and we watch a show or TV or we read or something like that. But I very much am a person where this is podcast. I don't come up here and hang out in here. That's my office. And so all of these places have some sort of meaning to motivate me in that setting to accomplish said task or said goal.
Yeah, I think that going into an office would be good for me in that sense. Mm-hmm. Not only that, I'll, like, get to meet people too. Like, I've been here for almost a year now.
Yeah. It's
insane.
That's wild.
Like, realistically, how much have I really expanded outside of, like, our circle? I've met a few people.
Yeah.
And so I feel like it would be good for me. Everybody in there was, like, late 20s, early 30s. So I'm like, okay, like, it's at least a decent environment. Seems super chill and laid back. So I don't know. If I get the offer, I'll probably end up taking this job.
Okay. So using your words against you, and not, like, in a bad way, just continuing the conversation. When you stopped working at that one company, you said, this will give me the time to work and hopefully make the strides to be able to have, like, a DTI be a full-time thing, or, like, even creating more content, whatever that is. Is that still top priority? And with you going into the office, can you focus on that as much? Or do you think that since you didn't give it as much of a focus in that 2 months, that it proved to you, like, all right, maybe I'm not ready to...
No, I think I'll be able to focus on it more. I think, like, I'm just a person who, when I'm at home, like, I'm just going to be... I'm going to find distractions.
Yeah.
I think I'm at, not only that, but I'm
going to... It'll be easy that Justin's bitch ass won't be here no more to distract you.
I'm
going to
search out distractions, though. But that's another thing, is, like, I'm going out back onto my own. Like, I'm not going to have a roommate anymore. So it's like, I also need at least some sense of stability in the fact that, like, it's all on me now. Like, I need to get a place of my own, which is going to be more money, which is fine. Like, I'm not going to... I could afford it now, but things would be super tight just serving.
Yeah.
And so... Not only that, but I'll be able to cut back my serving days. So my evenings will be opened up more if I take a full-time position somewhere. So I'll probably go down to 3 days a week again, and then I'll have more time to focus on other shit.
What industry is this potential? Are you going to try to stay in sales or get out of sales?
This is in sales, but it'd be selling, like, advertising space to sports publications.
Okay.
So, like, it's still, like, in a marketing realm where hopefully I can kind of transition eventually.
Yep.
If that's the route that I want to go. Because, I don't know. I don't like 5-year, 10-year. Like, I don't fucking know what I want to do 6 months from now.
Yeah.
I'm not going to think about what I want to do in 5 years. Like, I don't have a 5-year plan.
No.
My 5-year plan is just to work for myself.
Yeah. Facts. I saw a thing. It was like a video. It was like, hi to me in 5 years. And it's a topic that I wanted to bring up for us. Because I think it would be cool to just, like, sit here and dream of what we're going to make our life into. But not, like, set deadlines and be like, well, I want to do this in 2 years and I want to do this. But rather, like, talk about what our dreams and aspirations are and then look back 5 years from now and be like, damn, we accomplished all of that, dude. All of it. Now we set new ones. But I hate the 5-year plan too, or the what do you want to be in 5-year question.
Well, because it's set up by, like, the American dream is basically, like, what it's structured on. It's like, none of it's like, what do you actually want to do for yourself? It's all like, what does your career look like in 5 years? Mm-hmm. It's never like, what does your life look like? It's okay. Where are you at on the corporate ladder in 5 years?
Yeah.
And neither one of us think that way, which is why I think that that is an issue in the first place. But no one's asking, hey, what's your 5-year plan for, like, your fitness, for your faith, for your family? It's always career, career, career. And I think that that's the main issue in itself, is that everybody puts career at the forefront when you can't show up for your job if you're not showing up for yourself.
Yeah. Facts. I was having a conversation the other day, and we were talking about just how most people don't see the success of online businesses. So like the common everyday person, if they're posting on social media and getting like brand collabs or doing stuff like that, most people think and have this mindset as if like it's not sustainable on its own. You have to have a side job.
Yeah.
When in reality, like there could be enough money coming in that you live a very good lifestyle. But how older generations, and I would say even like our generations, still have the concept around like, if I were to go to them and say, I just became the director of my company in sales, I'm the director of sales at my company, everybody, oh my God, that's amazing, blah, blah, blah. But if I just said, I just left my company and I'm doing DTI full time, oh, are you sure that's smart? Are you sure you're going to be able to? Are you sure? Mm-hmm. Are you sure? And it's always that constant battle of
security.
Security and almost like having to prove something you shouldn't have to prove. Because like if you go to somebody and tell them like I quit my job and now I'm doing this full time, like my business, the question is 90% of the time going to be like, are you sure you can do that? Are you sure you're going to be able to pay for stuff? Are you sure you're medical? Are you sure this? And so it's just weird like thinking and having that discussion, because one day we're going to be having that where it's like, I don't work for corporate.
I do think the majority of the people in my life wouldn't be surprised when that day comes, but only because I've been surrounded by people who are doing that for so long. Since 2016, I've been like in this circle that's continuously been growing of people quitting their corporate job and going off on their own and doing things. And so like, I think that when that time does come, mm-hmm. especially now that I've been without a job for a little while, like my parents know like that I'm going to make it happen no matter what. Like I'm not going to fucking be homeless out here. If I got to go do whatever, I'm going to do it. So I feel like once that time comes, like it wouldn't be a bad conversation for me to have with my parents. People on the outskirts are going to have shit to say. They're going to chirp no matter what. But I think like my immediate like circle, they're all going to know that it's coming eventually.
Yep. Yeah, it'll be great and interesting when that day comes. Also, I keep looking at these cans because yours, like I'm taking a drink of this and the logo's on this side. You would think from a marketing perspective, branding perspective, you would want the logo to be
here.
They're
never on the same side though. Look where mine's at. Mine's on the side of it. Yeah, I think it's just the way that when they go through like the manufacturer, that it just seals it up. Huh. I don't think like they have a say in it. I think it's just the way that they put the tops on.
You feel like that would be something though that you would want to like display the logo. I don't know.
Yeah, but also yours, 100% real facing bad. Like mine is at least facing people.
Yeah.
Yours is facing straight at you.
Yep. Yeah, I don't know, kids. You know, go after your dreams, chase after the things you want, and I'm going to reiterate this again because it's something that I'm going through now, but when you feel as if you are at a crossroad, there is always something beautiful on the other side, whatever that is. And to me right now, it's unknown. I don't know what this crossroad is that I'm at, but I know that on the other side, it's going to be great. I know that there's a reason right now that I'm beating myself up about stuff. I know that there's a reason that I'm looking into things more. I know that there's a reason that I'm shifting my focus and energy in different directions. But again, I couldn't tell you where it is. But I know it's going to be a positive thing because I'm not going to stop. I'm gonna find the answers. I'm gonna find the why. I'm gonna find the reasoning for all of it, and that's through consistency. That's through little habits. That's through getting up day in and day out and still putting the work in to be able to see that at the end. And when I look back, I'll know why I took the path that I took. But Dylan is at a crossroad too with many things. But the key is,
I feel like I'm looking at like five different paths right now.
Yeah, dude. It's just so weird.
I'm like, if I take this path, it's going to lack in this thing. But if I take this path, this thing's fucked up. And I don't know, dude. I'm fucking lost. I'm all over the place right now.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Like when you graduate college or even like in your early 20s, like mid 20s, like you think you're going to have it all figured out, bro. And I couldn't be more lost at 30 years old. It's insane.
Yeah.
And I feel like everyone feels this way, but nobody talks about it. But I have no fucking clue what I'm supposed to be doing or where I'm going.
Yeah. It's like, you know what you value in life and what makes you passionate, what makes you drive. But it's like, what path do I take?
Yeah, how do I get there where I can see where I'm supposed to be? How do I get there?
Through the little habits, baby, that we always preach and never stopping. Because again, Society stops when it gets hard. Society stops when you don't know the answer. Society gives up. Like, we as humans always give up when we get to this point. But what is important and what is to always keep top of mind, don't fucking stop. Get up day in and day out and put the work in. Get off the couch. Don't become a couch potato. Stay working out. Stay consistent. Stay on the grind and know that it'll eventually change. And you'll look back and be like, holy fuck, that was it. Because it ties back. All of these are tying back. So that quote is, I think, at the top of this pyramid with all of our other discussions underneath of it. But it ties back to the episode where we were talking about, damn, why did I say so much words? Now I'm going to forget it. when we were talking about, oh, don't do this to me.
You got this. I believe in you.
Hold on. Just give me a second.
Take your time, man. Where is extending that watch time on YouTube right now?
You can speed this part up and put the little dude. I will get this. What were we just talking about?
We're talking about Crossroads, and then you went to you were said that this quote was at the top. You were trying to tie it back to an episode, but you never, you couldn't grab the episode.
Yep, that's where I'm still stuck. I'm going to remember it after this, and it's going to piss me off because it was going to tie in great to one
of
them.
Turn the mics back on.
What?
Turn the mics back on 20 minutes after we get off.
You're gone. You just record me on the phone telling me this and input it in. I don't know. Moral of this story is that, like, all of these things that we have been talking about have kind of revolved around this quote, because I think there is so much changing in life. But again, staying consistent, remaining within like who you are and your habits will keep you grounded to be able to find that answer and then see the light at that end of the tunnel.
Yeah. I have a very hard time like giving myself credit for shit. Like I don't like to pat myself on the back
ever.
The one thing that I will say is like that every time I go through like these situations, I don't stop. And so from the outside, like people probably don't even realize that I'm going through shit.
Mm-hmm.
And like that, I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing, but I will give myself credit in the fact that like, I stay consistent on all the shit I'm supposed to be consistent on. I get lazy. Everybody gets lazy eventually, though. Like,
yeah,
whether everything was going good or everything was going bad, like, I would have got lazy eventually. So, I'm actually going to give myself credit today that I'm fucking still on my shit because it's been rough. It's been rough.
I'm proud of you. You have had a lot going on. Changes.
It's always all at once, bro.
It is.
It's literally every time it happens to me, it's everything at one time.
Everything. From, like, all areas of life.
Yeah.
Like, this one, yep. Every single time. That's why I always try and, like, pull more out of you, because you handle these situations really well, which you don't give yourself credit for, and you undermine it where it's like, oh, no, it's just, it's this, or oh, no, it's this. And I always try and probe to get deeper, because I feel like there is something deeper. But, again, you don't ever give yourself validation or credit on the situations because of your mindset. Like, you don't let yourself...
Because I feel like if I go too deep on them, that it's going to pull me into a bad place.
Yeah.
If I talk on them, it's going to be negative, where it's going to be like dark. And I don't want to even give myself the opportunity to go to that space.
Yeah.
Because it's super easy to get stuck there. And so like, I do have people that I talk to about it. I mean, I talked to you about it before we get on air. But like, I have people that I talk to about it. It's just, I don't know. I don't like going all over the place. Because I'm not going to get... Like, I'm not going to give details on the podcast.
Yeah.
Like, that's just not going to happen.
Yeah, no, 100%.
So, like, talking about it without the details just seems like surface level. And I don't want to do that either. Like, yeah. I don't want to, like, blanket statement what's going on.
I'm almost more talking about, like, how during all of this you stay on path to, like, be consistent in the different things or your regimens that you do. Like, that aspect of it. Because, again, when life gets busy and chaotic... I always mess that up. Is it chaotic? Is that the right word?
Yeah.
Okay. When life gets busy and chaotic, it's very easy to like stop doing those mundane things that you're used to doing day in and day out.
See, I think it's easier to keep doing them.
Really?
Like for me personally, I think I'm in it so long. And maybe that's why like I don't talk about it. It's because like it's second nature at this point. I don't even, like I don't think about getting up to go for a run. I don't think about going to the gym. I don't think about, writing a newsletter. I don't think about uploading the video, because like those things all have to happen.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what's going on. Those things have to happen. Like those are non-negotiables.
That's what I was just going to say. I like that. I like that a lot.
Yeah. So like that might be why I don't speak on it, because
yeah,
I don't have any other option but to get it done.
I think we can fucking put the key in the socket now. Have non-negotiables in your life to keep you on track. Like you said, the gym, the healthy things, the videos, the uploads, like the things that you are working towards are the goals that you have. There are certain things where it needs to be a non-negotiable in your life. So yeah, have that set foundation of achieving X, Y, and Z, whatever it is throughout the day, and making sure that those things never, ever, ever stop, no matter where you are in life, because they will keep your mind right. They will keep your body right to be able to go through and get through the other areas and aspects that might seem a little bit bumpy or like at a standstill at that moment. But I like that.
Have you remembered the episode you were trying to find yet?
Nope. completely lost it. I kept talking. I should have just tied the point to it then and it would have fucking been perfect. But we're not perfect. At least I'm not.
Me either.
So that was good. I like that quote.
Yeah. It is a long one.
It is a long quote.
I didn't think I was going to fit it off on this note.
It comes with like three stuck together.
Even like when I went to write it down, like as I was looking at it in like my phone, I'm like, I don't think this is going to fit on a note. I'm like, I might have to paraphrase. But I didn't paraphrase. I just wrote small.
No, I'm glad you didn't. I don't think it would have been as impactful if you would have paraphrased.
No, it was good. And I'm honestly like kind of sad that I missed today's call, because it was like an open forum. It was like just talking about like where we're at in goal setting right now. And like most of the time, like there's a lesson and like we talk for like 10 minutes at the end. This one was a full hour of like just breaking it all down. And honestly, I haven't really talked about this on air or personally. This men's group, I think, is something that we could do in the future.
Really?
Maybe not even necessarily for men, just for people in general. But I feel like having a niche helps.
Mm-hmm.
But like very similar things to like what we already preach. And so like sometimes I feel like I'm just going through the motions, but I feel like it's still better to have that community of people who I'm doing it with.
Yep.
But like I'll have to show you like some of like the coursework that we do like on a weekly basis.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like broken out of like 8 week segments.
And okay,
like, they kind of repeat throughout the year at different points, because their whole thing is like that this is a continuous cycle. Like this isn't something that you just do once and you're set. Like
yeah,
you need to constantly be practicing these things. And so I think it's definitely something that we could do, even if it's in just 12 week increments. Like, hey, if you guys want to come in for 12 weeks, like here's what we could do. I think it's a lane that we could really hone in on.
Yeah.
Not to say like that the whole training and coaching thing isn't somewhere, but I feel like, correct me if I'm wrong, the other side of things is more where our passion lies anyways.
Yeah. I think they complement each other well, and we'll always have both of them. But I think
that yeah, this other has fitness too. It's just very like, here's three different programs. Choose yeah, one that best fits your life.
Yep. It's even kind of how First Form app lays theirs out. And they talked about it on the call the other day that they have on Tuesdays. And it was just how a lot of people are like, I want custom programs. I want custom programs. And it's like, cool, I can give you a custom program. It'll cost a lot more.
But there's also only so many ways you can customize something.
Yeah.
Like the basics are going to be the basics and they're the foundation no matter what.
Yep.
I can give you certain little movements, but unless you're training to be a bodybuilder or you're training for mobility or you're training for a certain aspect, you just need the basics.
Yeah. Yep. I was like on the call yesterday that I was on with a potential client that we might get. They were like, but I've heard this about this, and I've heard that I shouldn't be doing this. And I'm like,
where are you hearing all these things?
And I was like, it is so.
Vet your sources, dude. Like, don't believe everything you fucking see.
But that's the thing, though. Most people are in that predicament because they look on social media, then they talk to their doctor, then they this and they that. This person said that when they went to the doctor's office, their doctor told them that in order to, I won't even put it out there, but in order to achieve what they went to the doctor for, take this medication. And they're like, okay. And they got the prescription. They went home and they were like, wait, I don't want to take this the rest of my life. I don't want to take medication. Right. Then,
and you shouldn't have to. You don't have to.
Yeah. Then they have their health insurance every year. So they call them the fat lady because they'll call and say how their insurance can be cheaper if they hit these milestones in their health. And one of the things was like to lose weight. And so as she's like, okay, I'll look into this, started talking to people, everybody was recommending Ozempic. Do this. Jesus I lost Christ, 50 pounds. Get Ozempic. And I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with people?
Dude, I was on a run today. me and two other people. And this girl's talking about how her dad is 6 years old and he wants to get into running. And he was saying how if he really wants to do it, he needs to lose like 40 pounds. And even she said, I told him that if he really wants to lose 40 pounds that fast, he's going to have to get on Ozempic or something. Me and Phil were both like, we both just looked at her like, what the fuck did you just tell your dad? I don't understand people, man.
This world is fucked, dude. You want to know something else that's crazy? They were talking to somebody that was kind of like a personal trainer, and they were asking her how many steps she gets in a day and the how she gets trainer? Them. Yeah. Personal trainer was asking this lady.
Oh, I think they were asking the personal trainer.
Oh, no. The personal trainer was asking this lady how many steps she gets in a day. She was like, anywhere from like 10,000 to 11,000. Okay, how do you get those? And she was like, well, at work, I'm on my feet a lot. I'm walking back and forth to this, blah, blah, blah. The personal trainer told her that those steps are meaningless because they're her work and she needs to go out there and do some sort of cardio, running or something other than that, to get true steps that count.
I will say she should probably get more steps, though. Her body's accustomed to getting 10,000 okay, a day. If but, you're doing that every day, though, for X amount of years, your body does get used to it.
But the fact that she said that those steps don't count.
I would say you need to go run. Like, just go for another walk in that evening, get an extra 2,000-3,000.
Or why don't we look at the other areas? What does your diet look like, and what does your strength training or resistance training look like?
If weight loss is your goal.
But the fact that she, like, completely discredited those 10,000 steps just blows my mind.
I mean, I don't know. I'm somewhere in the middle on this. I don't think that they're dismissed, but I do think that her body would adjust to that. If I go out and I run 3 miles a day for the year, at some point my body's going to adjust and not burn as many calories.
I understand that. But to at the beginning, to say that those steps are meaningless without evaluating other areas to improve. Now, if she was going and working out 5 days a week and she was eating this diet and doing the 10,000 steps and still not seeing results, then you can maybe evaluate, like, take down the strength training a little bit, get a run in, get a bike ride, whatever that is. But to tell somebody that really doesn't have the confidence or knowledge in any of this.
Yeah, I guess I don't know all the factors here at play with this individual.
Yes.
Because I'm strictly talking for myself.
Yeah.
If I was going to do this.
I was just like, what the fuck? It's just, there's so much out there. And I stressed all the time. I was like, I don't know it all. This and that. I was like, all I know is we keep it on the basics and we change your life to fit your lifestyle.
So but the more I talk to other people, the more I realize I do know. Like, I'll be talking to people. I'm like, I know more than I think, because what I think is common knowledge and fucking just common sense, dude.
Oh, my leg is so asleep.
Is not. Your whole leg?
My whole leg from keeping it crisscross. Yeah, no, there's way too many avenues for knowledge and information.
Misinformation. There's too many people. There's too many voices. Stop focusing on. Find someone who you align with and like who you believe in and listen to them.
Yeah.
That doesn't have to be us.
It does not.
It doesn't. Just find somebody like and just listen to one person. Stop trying to take information from 10 different people, because it's all going to conflict and you're going to be all over the fucking place.
Yeah. Because then we got talking about it on like how one should eat. And they were like, well, I've tried this diet in the past and this and that. And then I tried this. And so I'm thinking about trying this one again. And I was like, okay, well, tell me what went well. It didn't work last time. Tell me what went well and tell me where it didn't go well. And she's like, goes into it. And then I was like, okay, well, what about this? What are you eating right now? She goes into what she eats today. And then I was like, all right, see, this is where I would start, because you can improve here. You can improve here. You can change this here. And guess what? Now you don't have to follow a diet. You don't have to change anything. You just know that you need to get this and this meal and this and this meal. And that's a step forward. And then once you start mastering that, then you can take the next step forward. I was like, keep it simple. Keep the basics.
You ever realize how much more health related our podcast has gotten over the years?
Good.
Like in the beginning, we were just talking about like mental shit. And every episode, it feels like we go into food and fucking exercise by the end of it.
And the disclaimer is, we are not professional advisors. Please consult a professional.
We are professionals. No,
it's like the commercial at the end. Consult a doctor before doing anything.
We've been trying to wrap this thing up three times now for like the last 20 minutes.
Sorry, dude.
I mean, I don't care. I've extended it as well. I'm just saying, we've tried to wrap this thing up multiple times.
I just hope my mic's working, because it's yellow and not green.
It's working.
Okay.
At least I think it is.
Well, keep the habits in your life when times are chaotic. Never doubt yourself.
You always remember it yet?
Why you got to keep bringing it up, bro?
Just in case before we close out, I want to see if he had it.
You really don't want to wrap this thing up. Keep the habits in your life. Keep the momentum forward. Keep moving it forward. Have the non-negotiables in your life. So that way when things are a little confusing, when things are a little bit mundane, you still have a direction and a purpose of where you're going to then be able to figure it out. And you will get through it. You will know which route is the route to go as long as you don't stop. So we don't have it all together. Your mama, she probably got it all together, but you don't. So get your shit together. Let's have a great rest of the year. It's already almost fucking April. So get on your shit because soon you're going to be trying to buy a 2 or 3 month program to get abs and lose all this weight before summer. Get your fat ass up off the couch right now. Start today. Hit us up. Support First Form. Support Athletic Brewing Co. Support Optic Nerve. Support.
We got a lot of them now. Honey Stinger.
Honey Bob Stinger.
Cane Footwear.
We got them all. Links in bio. It's on.
Peace.